everyone. So I'm going to be walking through how to use the April spelling menu, the packet that we sent home for kindergarten. Each day, if you see on the front, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, all have a different activity to do. I know on the front it says each week you will have a list of 4 sight words. For the first week of April, I would like you to just use the 5 just to make it easier on everyone. So you can start with these 5 words, and then after that week, you can use the sight word list that was sent home and pick any of those 4 to do for the next weeks of April after the April sight word list is complete. I know next week April will start in the middle, so just to make it easier on everyone, you could start this April spelling menu the following Monday. That way it's nice and easy to follow what activity is for each day. So it says for Monday to write each sight word 5 times each. So like I said, I'm going to be using the April sight words list, and I'm going to turn to the first page with the lines. I just on the top, the parents can do this, the students, if you'd like, you can do this. Just write Monday on the top to help keep track of what day you're on and where each of the activities are. So, like I said in my previous writing video, you can use highlighter if you'd like to keep track of each one. So if you see of is written 5 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then the next word and so on and so on. You don't have to use one line for each word. Since I ran out of space here, I returned sweep and just kept going until all of my April sight words, so the ones on this list, were written 5 times, nice and neat. I used my sky, airplane, and grass to stay nice and neat for that. So after that, Monday's activity will be done. Then if we look on Tuesday, back to the front page, Tuesday says your choice from spelling menu. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go inside and choose one of these activities on the spelling menu. Don't mind this just because I already did it, but for now this would all be blank. So I decided I wanted to use the kite words. So it says draw a kite for each of your spelling words, write one spelling word inside of each kite, then color your kites. So what I did is, since this one is a drawing activity, I can use the blank page. So I put a lot of blank pages in here just so we have places that we want to draw. You can also do it on the line paper, totally up to you. So again, I wrote Tuesday on top to help keep track, and I made some kites with my 5 sight words. Then I would go back into my April spelling menu and just check it off to show that I did that activity. Now, Wednesday says write each sight word in bubble letters and try your best. What I did was I had the bubble letters in here for you guys to reference if you'd like. So what I did is I went to the next page, I put Wednesday, and I made my bubble letters. You could do it in crayon, you could do it in pencil and color it in crayon, whatever you like, as long as you try your best. If you feel more comfortable doing the bubble letters on like a page that's blank, you totally can, as long as it's in order. No big deal if you want to go to a blank page, maybe you want to squeeze it in down here, that's totally fine. Whatever works for you. Now, the next day if I look, I have Thursday. So it says your choice from spelling menu again. So I'm gonna go in and look, and I think I like the pyramid words, which means you build a letter each time until you spell the whole word. So I'm gonna go into my book. And now I have all of this space on here, so I don't wanna waste paper and go to the next page. I'm just gonna use the rest of the page that's blank. So I'm gonna put Thursday here to keep track, and I have of, have, from, by, and my, all in the pyramid spelling like it says on the front. And then I'm gonna go back to my menu when I'm done and check it off. Now we're on to Friday. So Friday says practice test. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna need your parents for this, or a big person at home, is they're gonna tell you one of the sight words from the list that you used that week, and you're gonna try your best to spell it all by yourself. Then your big person, if anything was spelled wrong, can circle it, just like I did here. So I forgot the E in have. And since I spelled that word wrong, I'm gonna write it 3 times just for extra practice, so now I really remember my sight words at the end of this. And then your big person can just sign their name to show that you did the practice test. The practice test you can take a picture of it and send it to your teacher so they can make sure that you're keeping track of all your sight words. Then the next week, since I did my April list, because remember I have my April list here, the following Monday, I'm gonna turn the page. I'm gonna write Monday on the top again, and I can choose 4 of my words from this list that was sent home. Now, like I said, Monday Wednesday and Friday are all going to be the same each week. So Monday's always going to be writing the words 5 times. Wednesday's always going to be bubble letters. And Friday's always going to be the practice test. But Tuesday and Thursday are where you get to choose from your spelling menu. So you don't want to repeat the ones you already checked off. So now I can choose colorful words, story time, any of the ones that aren't checked off for my activities where I get to choose from my spelling menu. And then, like I said, the first week I signed there, but for the rest of the time, you can just sign next to the test because that will be where the picture is sent to your teachers. So I hope this helps. Like I said, there's a bunch of pages. You can use either side. You can use the line side. You can use the blank side for your drawings. Whatever you'd like to do, as long as you stay in order and you just label what day you're on so your teachers know what each activity is. So I hope that helps. Have fun.